Hello, my friends. I hope we will have more people today, and I hope it will be translated to our group. Yesterday we had technical difficulties. We posted video later that day, and let me know in the comments below if you are interested in repeating probably tomorrow a little bit more about how to make intros and how to make end screens and everything that I've talked in the first video. Maybe branding is something that you are interested in learning in this camp. Let us know. We will adjust future talks accordingly to your requests. And today I will talk about background settings and frames for your show. For example, boom. Right now, I have a frame around me. Why it's important to have it? Because I have extra branding here. I have my name here. And probably I just want to a little bit zoom out of my camera. And that would be a nicer situation. Of course, you might be interested in using this frame as other options, as computer maybe, or use your creativity. For me, this white blue background in company colors is perfect. A little bit of household items. So yesterday we talked about we talked about how you can participate in our camp. Yesterday we picked a style, and if you didn't pick your style, you can do it today. Then you need to set your branding. We will use it already today. And replace visuals in templates with your colors, which you set on your brandings. And logos with your logos, and then publish. That's the most important part. We expect you to publish with hashtag wave.video. Oh, sorry, hashtag wavecamp. And that's how we will know that you participate in our camp. You may publish here in the community. You may publish using this hashtag on social. But if you share your excitement about creating frames for speakers and backgrounds on wave.video, that would be great. Okay, that's something that I felt like I need to repeat because of the yesterday. And today I'll share screen with you and we will talk about how you set up your background in wave.video and how you use it in Restream or other platform probably, but for now we set everything ready for Restream. And I'm promoting that in Restream. Okay, here I start sharing my screen and just to show you some options we will talk later on, I can cover this with some information I need. For example, why to bother, why to set up these transitions and make all these visuals. We talked about that yesterday, but again, it will make your stream look more professional and you're probably using such things. Okay, you can explain your users easier with text if you need to, what to do, what key points and everything helpful. And with that, let me dive in and wave.video. And here we have background. What I want you to understand, first of all, why I'm showing wave.video. You've seen it before. Why all of a sudden I'm talking about live streaming? Okay, here's why. You probably noticed that we moved publish button from this nice place you all used to have it in on the left, where we had steps, and moved it next to your profile on top right. There is a reason for that. It used to be very simple publishing option before, where you only could publish videos. But now we will use it for all this nice stuff associated with live streaming. You can create background you love, personalized with logos, with everything in our product, and then download it to the stream products that you use to multi-streaming, which you love. And here it is how. We have these four options. Video, white label link, that's like exists here forever. But there are two new: GIFs and current frame as an image. Again, current frame as an image. Whatever I see in this area of Canvas will be published for me. Let's explore it together. What's happening? I clicked on this and I have options. There are three publishing formats: JPEG, PNG, or GIF. It depends on how the platform where you're gonna use whatever your frame want to publish accept. And for my purpose, most of the time I train myself to use PNG, because later on you will see if I have transparent format, JPEG doesn't support it. GIF supports it, but not every platform supports GIFs. So PNG for now, way to go. So in right in the middle, there is PNG. I check transparent background just in case. I don't have any transparent things here because it's just nice gradient that I set. And I click generate and download. Now this background is on my computer and I can upload it in StreamYard or Restream or another platform on desktop that you're probably using. Those backgrounds you can use across any platform. Now let's go back. So how I did create it? How I did create this gradient? On the right panel, right there, I have options how I can make my backgrounds. It could be solid. Then you see it's just a solid color. And we always recommend a bunch of colors for your project. Here you can choose them. And we also recommend brand colors. Yesterday we talked about setting up brand colors. You just need to copy this code go to manage brands and add another color here. I have plenty here. I don't need new ones. I just showing it for you. So I copy this, oops, perfect zone code, sorry. But yes, there, that's where you, okay, let's add something that I know, CCC, like completely in gray, 3, 4, 5, 6. And it could be a different font for you. But see, I got this perfect gray, which I will delete. I just wanted to show you how to add new color. Here you can upload logos or any graphics that you plan to use repeatedly over your background or overlay or whatever. And you can set different type of text right there. Let me move my picture little, so you will see everything. And yes, so you can have a color combinations here for text. It's also super helpful. You can choose different fonts. There are plenty, like hundreds and hundreds of Google fonts, basically all Google fonts. And that's how you set up your brand. And when you set up lots of colors in your brand, it's super easy to change background. You just click on the colors you want, or you pass your code here, or you choose like color wheel and just drag around to set your color. But again, if we're talking about your branding, probably you want to paste exact code here. And if you change that to gradient, then you need to add second color. And again, you can choose colors from your branding, or I don't know how you plan to choose it. It's about your creativity, about your branding. If you have exact gradient, which is probably have different direction or something like that, you can always upload it using media upload. Set media background. That's another option. And here we have plenty to offer. We have our huge library. When you type or choose backgrounds, for example, and you probably want images for your background or videos, whatever, but it would be easier if you know what you want. You can remove pricey options if you plan to go for free background, and then you can go and see what you might like as a background. And probably sometimes you want something that just disappear behind you, but sometimes you want something which pops up. You like everything you want right there. And the elements that you liked, and again, you can like images and then go ahead and pick some videos as a backgrounds. They also like very quiet background videos, which might enhance your live streaming, and you can just like something. And then you go to favorite folders, and here in the favorites, all that background that you liked before will be available for you. I did like a lot of stuff, as you can see, and maybe like a summer background like this will work for today because we have bright colors, right? So whatever picture you like in our library, you can use it as a background here, and maybe some adjustments for that particular background. Maybe not, because you need to keep in mind then when you're going to be in live stream, not all pixels of your background will be shown all the time. So sometimes placing logo in some safe place will work just fine for our purpose. And again, if you go to edit, media gradient, solid color, that's how you decide what you want. And for media, you have a choice. You can play with it, you can replace it, and so on and so forth. So again, solid background, some previously selected background video, slight animation here. That's how you set your background. So first you need to decide for yourself what you want. And I recommend following, if you some recommendations about background. If you have busy stream like me today, when I'm talking, there is a lot of demonstration happening next to me. It's all very busy, and you probably want very plain, quiet background. If it's in fact just you and probably in a small frame, you can make it more popping up with something more interesting, something like when I stop sharing and remind you about this frame I had before. It makes me kind of feel like I'm in TV or something, and I feel like I need to straighten my back. Whatever works for you, right? And if we go back to sharing the stream, the screen, sorry, then I'll go, what does it mean? Why do I have these two pictures? That's because I already kind of ahead of myself and clicked on the wrong thing. Okay, so here's some example. When I have a background, but I already place some graphic on top of it, and that might work as a thumbnail for your video, but we will have more about thumbnails tomorrow. Or it can work as a other options, division in between parts of your talk, or end screen, or just information for your users, as I showed for you before. So there are some options. With that, let's talk about frames. And if you have questions about background, you still have time, you can ask them in the stream. I'm gonna go check what's going on in chat. If you have some questions, might be a good time to ask them. Hello, David from sunny England. Oh, that's something interesting. I watched the recording this morning of yesterday, unsuccessful live event. Whew. So no need to repeat it for me. Great, I'm glad that you're happy with whatever you could see. If you still have questions, because the most sad part of this unhappy attempt yesterday was the part that you couldn't ask your questions. And if some questions left for today, that's fine. We will have Q&A in the end. Okay. Okay, great. So not everything is clear so far, as I understand, with the background. Now let's talk about frames. How I created this frame, right? This frame that I have in the beginning. And another maybe demonstration of another frame before we start to talk about them, right? Like, for example, frame like this. It made me almost equal to my screen share, almost as important. So I feel great about this opportunity to do it. And it looked different. Sometimes you want that flat setting. Okay, now probably less of me, more of the screen. And again, right now I'm sharing the screen and probably not so exciting, but when I have somebody else coming and I need more information or I need double branding, couple of brands for co-marketing event, those frames are super helpful. Okay, so how do I set them? I go to templates, and here on the left, we have live streaming options. I go to all styles. Again, find the style that I like, and where is, here's our style, very familiar. And I can choose, as you can see, this frame, and I'll choose it and show how to change background around it. Yeah, probably let's start with this one. So I select it, I add in the end, I don't want to replace anything. And I click this button. Oh, let me share it somehow like this so you can see more of what's going on. Like, oh. Okay, right there in the lower corner of my screen, you can see this two sides arrow. If I click on it, everything is set on my timeline. Now I can see the last frame better. And here's my frame. Why do we have template for that? Because this area, when you can see a speaker, is slightly different. And you don't want to end up like doing this and cutting part of your stream or doing that or doing this. Something you actually want this frame to be centered in the stream when you publish it, right? And I already moved it a few times, so I want to click end. Okay, that was one extra clicking. So note, here is light mode on top, see? On top next to publish, wave video, those two buttons, back and forth, super helpful. I use them all the time. If I deleted something I wanted back, I use undo. If I undo a few more times that I needed, I use this one, redo. So pay attention to those, they're super helpful. I just use them. So now, this area where you have this transparent part, super important, it aligned for restream at the moment, and frame around is just the background. Right now it's a gradient with my company color, that's what the idea originally was, but then I can set media. If I set media background. I probably will go with some of my pictures that I previously liked. Yeah, that one, remember? I replace, and now I have this nice frame, which I plan to publish. And we can see how it will work here in the stream later on. So I'm super excited. I don't need job title here. And if I want name, I want this name to be mine, right? Maybe I just don't want it because Restream will show it automatically. Okay, so I delete this extra pieces. I move again logo to this part, which is more visible. Probably will make it larger because the background is super busy. It's hard to notice now. And I go to publish, current frame. We know the routine, PNG, transparent background, generate, boom, download. And now I will upload it in Restream and show you. It's taking a little bit of time to upload it here. And let me stop sharing. And wait a second, uploaded the wrong one. Let me change name of it. Flowers, because I picked the wrong one. And I'll upload the right one one time. And flowers, this one. Ta-da! It's right here. Now I feel a little bit more like in a sunny Boston, almost like in a sunny England. Okay, yeah, definitely this looks like English garden to me. Okay, anyway, here I have new background and it makes some, you know, festive mood for my stream. I like it. So I like the seasonal backgrounds when you can choose different options. And let's go back, remove the background, share the screen like this. And I'll offer you some other ideas, what kind of backgrounds you may want to create it for your talk shows. So I click again, copy of that, and I just want, I'm happy with everything, but I want to have seasonal background. For example, here's, there will be upcoming 4th of July. So let's find something with 4th of July. Not very English, England related holidays, but anyway. 4th. That's the upcoming holidays. That's something I can think about. And again, this is video, which I'm thinking how background, if it's going to work or not. Maybe this one as a background will be better option, or maybe image will be a better option. Ooh, this is kind of cool. Intense. Video, I liked video better. A little bit of movement won't hurt. But on the other hand, yeah. Okay. On the other hand, it's more predictable and less destructive. So videos are cool for the background, but sometimes you want all the attention to be on what you share or on you. So I prefer some, you know, background to be a background, not the main player in your stream, unless you talk about backgrounds as me today. Then you can go crazy. Okay, flag, I think that will work. And publish, boom, again, generate, download. You know what, I think it's time to do, I don't want to I will upload it definitely, but let's play this next one. For example, this one. Again, when you go to template, there are a bunch of options with live streaming that you might utilize. And if I pick this template and add it to my stream, I plan to use it as a guinea pig. And show here how you can set this media background. Media background, replace, boom. So very, very 4th of July thing, right? So let's delete extra covering. Maybe we want to make people sure that they still remember what this flag is all about. It's Independence Day, 4th of July, so you can type some, add some text somewhere underneath. Like, let's see, a text. Ooh, that's not what I meant. But anyway, some text. 4th of July, Independence Day, right? Independence Day. And again, you can set your own colors here and be creative. And let's remove extra information and move from gray background our logo, so somebody will notice it on white because it was meant for a lighter background. Okay, now we want to center this stuff and publish. Boom. Current frame, generate, download. Now I will upload it in our stream. I'll stop sharing for a moment. Upload. Okay, the time is it. 11:28. That must be this one. I'm just afraid I will bring up the wrong one again. Let's see. Oops, right one. Okay, let's share the screen. And here we are. I'm sharing my screen on this colorful background. And if it would be a live event on Independence Day, everybody would understand, would be happy. But for now, I think we can remove it. Yeah. It's less colorful, less token, but you got the idea. Again, I'll stop screening at the moment. That was about what I planned to show today. And I expect you to create one video which will have the background of your choice and overlay, we call it overlay, graphic of your choice for your frame. If you know that on your show you have guests, so it makes sense to create something with a guest. And I'll show you one more trick before I do, how you also can use some frames. For example, I do a screen share, and that makes me take only part of my screen. And on the left, I have this screen share. But for example, right now, I play some overlay. It's also frame, which I created before. And it's half a split screen. And right there, I have four easy steps. Pick the style, set your brand. I hope you already done it yesterday. If not, you can do it today. Set your brand, replace visuals in the template with your own. And by visuals, I mean media background or colors or everything, and publish with Wavecamp hashtag. Again, if you didn't submit your video for yesterday, you can do it today. Today is super simple life, super simple day, just background, these frames, and you're done. for today, unless you want to go back and do some intro. Okay, with that, I want to do something else right now. I stop sharing. And I want to tell you, think about questions. If you have some questions, that's a great time to ask them, because it's time for... And again, Q&A time is a great time to look in your notes and see if you forgot something, because nobody sees your face at this moment. So all this dividers of your show, all these extra media pieces, they give you a little bit of break, and sometimes you need it. And so here, another idea what you can do, you can have this overlays, which tells what part of the show you are right now. And it gives some, you know, flow to your show. For example, if somebody will just start watching my live stream from this very moment, they know it's Q&A time. So I don't have to explain them this 100 times. They tuned in at this time. They know what this time. Probably I can think about, this market of overlays, this market of templates for live streaming, it just started to develop. If you have some idea, it's also great if you share these ideas with us, because we're still thinking about what kind of graphics we need to offer you guys. And I was thinking Q&A graphic is something that you might be interested in. And I will talk about this type of graphics more. I will talk about them on Thursday. Tomorrow I will talk about thumbnails. Talking about grid frames. Hello. Online Learning Academy. Awesome. Okay, guys. I don't see much questions. Great. Thank you for sharing your ideas and knowledge. That's all great. But still, any questions today? If not, please do some graphics today, do some grids. Can a graphic be animated? Yes. For that, you need to use... if you want to... So here's the trick. Depends on what platform you use. You can do transparent videos in wave.video, but then your stream should be desktop stream. I'm talking about Restream these days, because we have event with Restream, and in Restream you can only upload GIFs, so it could be animation, but GIFs cannot be too huge, so you might want to think about quick animation that can be done in GIF format. Otherwise, but we will do more of animated stuff. Good question, I love it. And it's a question from Online Learning Academy. So guys, if you are thinking about learning more, if just doing graphics is not enough for you to start live streaming, you might want to connect to this gentleman and ask him more questions. Okay, so any other questions? Got it, thank you. Yeah, I'll talk a little bit more about animated options. If you don't have any questions, please do post your videos, do post your graphics. The best part is that this graphic didn't appear right away and was perfect. I got a couple of things to correct it from designers. For example, originally it was like very straight, but they say like, why don't we add an extra angle into it? And it looks better, so much better. And why don't we align this and that? So if you create your background, your graphics, our designers will give you feedback. You won't be sorry. You won't be even think about little tricks that they will bring into your branded graphics, which will change everything. So take this opportunity. They excellent designers, excellent. You won't find them, you know, as freelancers anywhere. Okay, so again, I encourage you to create something, create intro, create graphics, create frames and everything, backgrounds, and post it with hashtag WaveCamp. With that, I'm saying you goodbye and see you tomorrow. Tomorrow we will be talking about thumbnails and something else, but mostly thumbnails. And I'll share you with you another feature, removing backgrounds. This is much wanted feature from everybody else. Tomorrow will be demo from me, how you can make thumbnails using background removal from your photos. And that's super excited. Exciting. I was like very much into it and played with it like 2 days when I got my hands on the feature. So I almost envy you. Okay, with that, bye and see you tomorrow here. With that, I'll show outro.